The first upgrade of our Creality Ender 3 3D printer is already beyond us. However, the printer still has a lot of imperfections. Today, we are going to take a look at the print surface. As mentioned in the intro, in today's episode, we are going to take a look at the print surface of our 3D printer. This depends on the kind of printer you have. In this video, we are going to stick with this series where we talk about the Creality Ender 3D printer from 2022. The printer comes with a removable flexible build surface. The bottom layer of the print looks nice. Materials like PLA or PETG stick to it very well. The build surface is held on the heated bed with clips. Unfortunately, when it's heated, a slight deformation occurs. As a result, the first layer may not stick evenly and properly to the build surface. This is not such a problem for small objects, but rather for a larger one. The advantage of this build surface is the ability to remove the print by simply bending it. I also received this build surface sticker with the printer. Basically, it is a sticker that is glued onto this build surface. I'm sure someone might think of sticking this build surface sticker directly on the heated bed. But I'm begging you, don't do it. Taking the print directly off the printer can damage the printer. In our case, mainly the Y-axis wheels. If anything, stick this build surface sticker on a magnet, a piece of thin steel sheet or a mirror, for example. It is also possible to purchase this magnetic version of the previous build surface. The difference is that the build surface is glued on a piece of magnet. The other part of the magnet is then glued to the heated bed. However, you need to be careful about the orientation of the magnet. It may happen that the pad will not stick to the magnet. Again, the advantage of this magnetic build surface is the ability to remove the print by simply bending it. The disadvantage is that it exactly follows the heated bed underneath. Why this is a problem, I will tell you in a moment. We will stay with the magnet for a while. The heat of recent times is a steel sheet with a thin layer of PEI. Most thermoplastics stick very well to this surface. Some of them way too much. That's why you need to use an interlayer for some materials. Again, the advantage of this steel sheet is the ability to remove the print by simply bending it. This steel sheet can be purchased in several different designs. The cheapest is the version with PEI film glued on. Prints on it have a beautiful smooth first layer. There is also a variant with a PEI powder coating. This variant has a rough surface, but very good adhesion to most materials. There is also a variant where you have a different surface on each side. This allows you to get the best of both worlds. The heated bed on this 3D printer is a 3mm thick piece of aluminium with a resistive path and a temperature sensor. By applying an electric current to this resistive path, the resistive path heats up and gradually warms up the piece of aluminium. And here we come to the problem. Specifically, a problem called thermal expansion of materials. Because when aluminium heats up, it deforms slightly in shape. For us, this means that our print surface, when heated, will not be flat. I'm not saying that it's ever been. All the print pads I just showed you have one problem in common. It is that they more or less follow the shape of the heated bed underneath. The heated bed, which is aluminium and deforms easily when heated. So if you calibrate the height of the first layer on the heated bed, the height will not be the same across the entire build surface. We can compensate this in three ways. The first way is by manually mapping the unevenness by building a mesh of the differences. The mesh bed leveling method is used for this and we have already covered it in another video. The second is by using a calibration probe and automatically mapping the unevenness. Here I have a couple of calibration probes to show you. For example, it can be a touch sensor. Either a simple push-button switch or a more sophisticated BL-Touch. This type can be used on any surface. Or a contactless sensor, such as an inductive sensor. The sensor comes in handy if you choose to use a steel sheet. We also have already covered this method in another video. The third and probably cheapest way of compensating for surface unevenness is actually a bit of a scam. Instead of compensating for the unevenness of the surface, we just make the surface flat. A simple 3 to 4 mm thick glass or mirror can provide the flat surface we so desire. Plus, it's available from any good glazier. It is even possible to buy glass with a thin layer of material which, when heated, increases its adhesion. Once cooled, its adhesion is again reduced and the print can be freely removed. In fact, it behaves pretty much like, for example, the already mentioned PEI. Due to the significantly lower thermal expansion of the glass, there is no risk of any surface deformation. To clean most of the surfaces in this video, just use dish soap or isopropyl alcohol. Dish soap perfectly removes grease and various dirt. Just use a paper towel or a dish sponge to clean the surface. After cleaning the surface, dish soap should be rinsed and the surface dried. Isopropyl alcohol removes many chemical contaminants in addition to grease. An ordinary paper towel is sufficient to clean the surface. Compared to dish soap, isopropyl alcohol has the advantage that it evaporates itself after cleaning the surface. Try not to use any other type of alcohol or acetone. Most surfaces will decrease and lose their adhesion. Now let's see how to increase the adhesion. You don't need to use basically anything to print on all the surfaces mentioned. If you clean these print surfaces, their adhesion will be sufficient in most cases. There are many different products to increase adhesion. All of these products work by enhancing adhesion once they are heated. When they cool down, their adhesion decreases and the print can be taken off freely. These products are also suitable as a protective interlayer for printing certain materials on certain types of surfaces. For example, printing PETG on clear glass or PEI can end up very badly. Probably the best choice for most of us is the 3D Lock. Just apply a thin layer of this product to the cool print area and let it dry. Once the heated bed is heated above 30 degrees, the applied layer gets activated. Its adhesion will increase and materials such as PLA, PETG, ABS, ASA, TPU and others will stick even on perfectly smooth glass. After cooling below 30 degrees, the adhesion of this layer decreases and the print can be easily removed. The layer can be removed from the surface with water or isopropyl alcohol. On the same principle works Demafix. The higher the temperature, the stronger the adhesion. The temperature of loss of adhesion is as low as 60 degrees. It is therefore more suitable for materials such as ABS, ASA, TPU and similar. It can be removed from the surface with water or isopropyl alcohol. Probably the cheapest option is ordinary glue stick. Application is done by applying a thin layer on a cold surface in the X and Y directions. Always only once in each direction. The behavior of the glue is identical to the previous product. The only difference is that the glue stick also works on cold surfaces. Just wait until it dries a little. It can be used with most materials such as PLA, PETG, ABS, ASA, TPU and even nylon and polycarbonate. It can be removed from the surface with water. Some people even use a hairspray with success. Personally, I have to say that I have never been lucky enough to have hairspray work at least as well as regular glue sticks. Other products can be used as well, but more of those another time. I personally use 3D Lock for most of my prints. On rare occasions, I will reach for Dimafix as well, but it doesn't happen very often. Maybe I can say some of my recommendations at the end. If you don't want to invest in automatic calibration yet, go for the mirror and 3D Lock. If you already use automatic calibration, then reach for a double-sided steel sheet and again 3D Lock.